Resurgence this patch, I think the games go late enough where the hero can actually have an impact, and it's actually quite good this game. You wouldn't think it, but Darkseer is extremely good against Doom because it's usually a hero that picks up some aura items, and then he's always going to have a creep that has some sort of aura, so you're actually going to steal a lot of auras from
the carry player as well. And on top of that, you have S-Force Puck and Sibba playing the Doom, who's played it rather well in the past couple of games. So this is not going to be an easy game for Denial by Animation. So Simba, you have to be careful there, buddy. He's gonna get spotted. They'll ping him out, but they're gonna back away. They're not gonna go for any sort of kill. So we are gonna get into the roster real quick of Denial. Funzi on your Darkseer heading up to the offlane down bottom. It is gonna be Paris playing Wraith King. Creo is gonna be on your Io. We will have fucking Mad or Mad playing your Nyx Assassin down bottom. Drawl is going to make his way towards the mid lane, playing that Viper. So that'll be your Denial Radiant roster.
And for Dire, we're gonna have Team Secret in the top lane. We're gonna have Kuroki playing the Tearblade, being supported by No Tail on the Disruptor and Puppy playing the Ancient Apparition. In the mid lane, we're gonna have S4 on the Puck, and off lane, we're gonna have Simba playing the Doom.
Running at Creo right now. He will tether his way out of there. He actually took a lot of damage early on from Scorched Earth, and he doesn't actually. So he went for Scorched Earth level 1, which does give you a bit of staying power in lane and also allows you to do some decent damage. And I think that's why he skilled it, just to maybe try to get the kill on Creo, but no such luck there. So he won't have Devour until level 2, but that's not that big of a deal unless he can shut down pretty hard. And already you can see that there is this ward on the high ground that they're going to counter real quick from Secret. They knew exactly where it was placed, and it's not a big surprise either. They're going to head back top. They're not going to look for a gank mid. Geralt is easily ganked because he is a Viper, mind you, so something to keep in mind.
And I know you're talking about Denial's draft. I definitely think if you were going to compare these two drafts at face value, I would say Secret got the better end of the draft, just because I don't actually think there's enough to deal with the Terrorblade illusions. I think the main hero they can deal with, but the illusions they might have a lot of problems with. So I think shutting down this Tearblade at some point is going to be really important to Denial's success, because like once he gets the Manta, Scotty, and Butterfly, I just don't think there's enough.
He'll be running at your towers, and all of a sudden you're
Yeah.
not going to have a base to go back home to. So I think it's going to be very important that they deal with him in some way, shape, or form. How they're going to do that, I honestly have no idea, because they're not going to have any ganks coming in. You won't really have the way to deal with the Tearblade with the Darkseer until like level 9, 10, or 11. I mean, you can try to run at him with Iron Shell, but that generally doesn't work. So he's already up at 6 last hits, unsurprisingly. Down bottom, they're not really ganking Sibba, but he's getting a decent amount out of this lane with 4 last hits. Wraith King is sitting at 5, so this offlane's going significantly well for Simba. No Tail and Funzi going toe-to-toe in the top lane. They'll just throw out some right clicks harassing each other. Funzi's getting zero experience, so Simba is already having a great time in comparison to that of the top lane for the Darkseer.
Yep, so Funzi actually with no experience on this offlane Darkseer, and it's very difficult against this lane that Secret have if he ever gets caught out in. What did. No Tail actually didn't skill anything yet, but if he gets caught in a kinetic field or even a glimpse back, he might just fall to the right clicks coming out from the chilling touch, so has to be really careful in the stop lane.
Yeah, and they'll also have Metamorphosis as well. So if they get a kinetic field like you talked about, they pretty much get a kill. Which is why you see the Darkseer heading to the jungle. He knows that he's not getting anything, and a level 1 Darkseer in the jungle is kind of difficult, but he should be able to manage to get some CS and experience as well. He does have a scout shield, so.
It's actually one of the better level 1 jungling heroes. He just doesn't ramp up as fast as the other jungling heroes, so. Could do decently well. Usually, what you see people do when they jungle Darkseer is they stack this large camp over here, and then they farm the medium one for levels, and then once they hit level 3, they end up clearing this big camp. Because you can just
So.
eye on the neutrals and not take any damage.
Yeah. And that'll provide a decent amount of experience, but he's not really stacking it. He got the hard camp and then went back to the mid camp, but the medium camp rather. So mid lane, this is the one lane I think is going well for Denial. I mean, obviously bottom lane they are getting farm for their Wraith King, but Geralt is doing well in CS. He's 2 ahead of S4. He was harassing S4 pretty well, but now S4 has his bottle, so he shouldn't die or take as much harass easily. But Geralt is doing well again. It's a Viper, so you're expected to kind of do well in this matchup.
I
And that's it,
think
really.
he should be winning a bit harder, actually. This is a matchup that is heavily favored in Viper. And the only reason that Puck is even able to... Like, in the mid lane, it's not as terrible for Puck.
Oh, Glimpse, top lane, Metamorphosis, body blocks from Note. He didn't have mana. He actually had Thunderstrike instead of Kinetic Field, but they don't even need it. Kuroki comes in, and the body blocks from your Disruptor get your first blood down bottom. Simmons getting jumped on, it looks like. There's going to be the Tether coming through, but Scorched Earth keeps him alive and well. He's good to go, man. He's fine.
Yeah, and I mean, that's the danger of the Starks here coming back into the top lane against the Disruptor and Ancient Apparition. They just do so much damage if they can glimpse you.
Impale, Wraithfire Blast, bottom lane, Tether's gonna go in a second, and it will. It'll slow him down, no Scorched Earth. Simba will fall here, it looks like. No, Stick Charge, Mana Burn is not enough. Paris wants the kill, he's gonna get it. It's actually the Spirits coming in from Creo that secure it. Paris is like, I want to run at you, and we're going to get a kill.
He actually almost lived solely because of Frost Armor. It gives you 8 additional armor, plus the 30% move speed slow and 20 attack speed, which is very significant in the early game. So, I mean, giving him a lot of additional effective HP up against the physical damage, but it just wasn't quite enough to survive in the end.
Getting to that Scorched Earth, and he had just used it to avoid the gank earlier, so...
So both offlaners do end up falling... I would say that Simba is definitely getting a lot more out of this offlane. He is at 7 CS compared to the, well, 10 of Darkseer, but all of these are neutrals, so getting it a lot more experience as well.
More importantly than anything else is Kuroki sitting at 33 last hits now, and if he continues to get this type of farm, which he most assuredly will, I don't know what you do here if you're Denial. This is going to be kind of tough. This is not a game where you're like, Kuroki just farm away, it's fine.
Well, I think in the early game it's okay to let him farm like this, but at some point you have to start dedicating resources to shut him down. Like, if he gets Treads and Yasha, like, that's not really a big deal because he's still really easy to kill. But once he starts getting up some tank items like the Manta style and then starts working towards Ascati, that's when he really starts to get dangerous because you can't kill him.
S4 has Dreamquail. He might use it here. Mad's gonna come in. There's the Dreamquail onto 2. There's gonna be the Cold Feet as well. Kinetic Field going in. They're going to get caught out of Lucio Orb. Are they going to get a double kill here? No, they pick up Kuroki. The Viper Strike coming in from the backside came through, I believe. And he actually got glimpsed back to the mid lane while that was all happening. But they got the kill regardless, and they don't lose a single hero. What a pickup for Denial to kill Kuroki there. Even if Viper gets sent back mid, he's happy with that. He gets farm and a kill.
Yeah, that was a really overzealous play from Secret, I think. I mean, I understand what they were going for. If they are able to get the glimpse on the Viper, then, you know, it just becomes a 2v3, but they were just so far under the tower that they were taking additional damage from the tower, and they weren't able to get any reinforcements off of the Quail, so they weren't actually able to do any damage.
It was a good idea, but when Kuroki dove and got killed, they needed to back away, and obviously they did so, but that was just, like you said, a bit overzealous, and, well, Secret now... With a death to Kuroki, he'll continue to farm up at the top lane. Not the worst thing in the world for him, but they can't make this a habit if they want to keep getting farm and securing the late game. So Kuroki will just probably continue to CS and not really worry about diving. So.
And, I mean, he's still sitting at the highest CS in the game at 47 compared to the 41 up Paris. They're doing a good job in terms of CS. It does look like we are going to see a Midas build coming out from the Wraith King. I really like the Midas when you're playing this core position Wraith King. It does look like they are going to go on Funzi.
Oh, he's dead, man. He's just dead. Good kinetic field. And he really waited for that glimpse as well. So No-Tail is being very patient with these kills. And he does have his arcanes already. So about a disruptor, we always talk about if you don't get a good start, it's very difficult to play from behind. But, well, he's got a good start now, I think.
The real reason why Disruptor is so good against Darkseer is you just... At level 2 even, he can Thunderstrike him to give to keep vision, and then he can just walk next to him while he's surging away, and he's going to be able to glimpse him back. And now that he has even 3 points in glimpse, it's even more effective. It's just so good against Darkseer, especially in this early game.
There's going to be a TP, and they really want this tower. It is in deny range. There's going to be the Cold Feet. No-Tail is taking in some damage here, but they will get the tower surging with the glimpse back coming in. Again. They don't have the kinetic field. Now Fudge is going to try to run at No-Tail. It's not going to work out. Mad wants the kill as well. He's like, please, please give me No-Tail. He has the impale. He's going to pop it. He will get the kill, but in the end, he gives away a death to Secret as well. Kind of aggressive from Denial there. It's a bit clowny. And also, Puck was chasing after the courier bottom. Almost got the kill. 13 HP. Ooh, that's rough.
Yeah, it wasn't You know, it could have gone a lot worse for Denial had Kuroki gotten more of those kills than even possibly the tower kill. He ends up only getting one kill in that exchange, and the tower kill actually goes to No-Tail, so could have been worse, I think, for Denial. I think they're quite lucky with what just happened, because if Kuroki had, let's say, gotten both last hits on those kills and the tower, he could have maybe just completely taken over this game, because he would have a Yasha completed right now.
Yeah, instead he's 1,800 gold, so a couple hundred away from that Yasha. He doesn't seem to mind. He'll just continue to get CS, and when he gets the Yasha, Manta style, Scotty, he'll be a force to be reckoned with, and they're not really dedicating enough to stopping him at this point. They can start ganking the jungle. I want to see what the Viper has at this point. Treads in an Aquila, maybe a mech coming out next for Viper, as we see so often on this hero. It's pretty nice.
I'm actually really surprised that Funzi continues to go back to this top lane. I actually really like the choice from him to just, at level 1, say, you know what, there's too much kill pressure in this lane, I'm just gonna go jungle from level 1. And I would have liked to just see him stay in the jungle, and then as soon as they felt like they had enough lane pressure in this bottom lane without the Nyx, just have Nyx rotate into the offlane and have him sort of become that offlaner while Darkseer jungles. But I just feel like constantly putting the Darkseer in the top lane, he's just given up too many kills tri-lane of Secret.
Goodbye, Creo. Gets doomed up. Paris is going to come in with reinforcements, and they want No-Tail yet again. And they have another hero wrapping around. That is the Viper, so No-Tail is going to have to find a way to TP out of here, but it's going to be difficult. He's going to pop the Kinetic Field, the Static Storm as well. Now he'll try to TP out. This is a really smart play coming out from No-Tail. He'll survive. Simba TP's out as well. And they end up losing nothing in the process after using the Doom on Creo. Wow, smart play. So smart.
Yeah, I missed that initial kill, but I did see the follow-up. Really good TP from No-Tail. They were also in the top lane going onto Kuroki with the Vendetta, but just not enough follow-up damage, so he gets alive there as well. And I can sort of understand why they keep putting, like, sending this Darkseer on the top lane, because when you have a melee carry farming the safe lane against the Darkseer, it can actually at times... Oh, this could be...
That Ice Blast missed. Junkrell's gonna go regardless. They just blow up one. They might blow up two as well. Waiting Rift already ran. S4 is just going with right clicks. And now he's gonna try to man up Funzi. That was not your best option. And S4 ends up getting a double kill. His Blink Dagger is about 100 gold away as well. They were just both farming that camp leisurely. They did not expect to get got on. And boy, did they.
I mean, who expects Puck to be sitting there with an Invis? A really nice rotation from S4. I'm not sure what happened to the AA ults.
Yeah, I don't know. That's a big question.
I think maybe he lagged or something. I don't know.
Probably. That makes the most sense.
I'll just assume he lagged, or he wasn't paying attention.
Giving the benefit of the doubt. Wraithfire Blast did go on Kuroki. He's actually in this bottom lane alone, and they're putting four heroes dedicated towards this tower. He might want to try to deny this, but I think he needs to back away. He does have an illusion here, and now he's going to head towards the mid lane, it looks like.
Yeah, that's not happening. They're just going to give this tower away, and they're perfectly fine with this. They're going to send the AL to try to annoy them a little bit, but...
They might try to wrap them afterwards. Yeah, I mean, Creo gets low from that Ancient Apparition ult. It just does so much damage. S4's going to come up there. Nice usage of the Spike Carapace, as he was going to pop the Illusion Orb and maybe jaunt up, but... Paris.
Yeah, they just have to run. Paris is too scary right now.
Reincarnation Midas treads.
Well, they're going to get
Bracer as well. Relocate coming in while Replica's down. There's going to be the usage of the Disruptor ult. No-Tail caught out. Wraithfire Blast, he's done as well. So one for one, there's the Dream Quill. S4 has no Illusory Orb for a couple of seconds. The Thunderstrike going in. Relocate. Illusory Orb. Waiting Rift is there. He's going to use a triple kill for S4. The Puck player is back. What a man. Jumps in, gets three. Not even an issue for S4. His Blink Dagger, he gets it and obliterates the side of Denial. That's going to provide him some treads as well if he wants.
And really well played from S4 in that fight. I'm just not sure what Denial can do. I mean, they're losing these engagements, and Terrorblade's not even a part of this game yet. He's just farming away in the jungle. He's probably going to have his Mantis style. And he's got 1,300 gold with the Yasha, so probably at about 15 to 16 minutes, if he keeps farming at this rate, he's just safely farming up the jungle. You know, Secret has this really nice placed ward here, so they can see if there's a rotation coming through the lane. And, I mean, he's just really safe right now.
This is really, really solid for Secret, because not only do they have Kuroki like you talked about, but there's a Doom Midas up now. He hasn't really been involved either, so these fights are really not going the way of denial. Paris is going to try to fight onto S4, but he'll just elude her over and jaunt away. And like I said, he has the treads now. They're all rotating up top. Puppy is here. He's going to TP out. I think they noticed that he was around, but he does make himself out of there, luckily enough. And they'll start putting pressure on the towers, I think, but I don't know if they really can take a fight yet. Funzi is only level 7 here, so he doesn't even have level 3 vacuum. He's not even close to it. He does have the 1-point wall early. Vendetta? No. I think there was Vendetta, but it's over now. They're mad. Ice Blast going in. Static Storm. Jarral is just going to die. In fact, he's not even going for mech. There's the Wraithfire Blast. They relocated in. Impale onto one. There's the Doom onto Mad, though. And it looks like he should fall here. Maybe not. They're going to come in. Reinforcements are going to go. They glimpse back Paris, I believe. Simba's going to get caught out. Big wall coming in. Doom still onto Mad. And Paris is just running in. He still has his reincarnation. He's going deep. And he's going to get it popped. S4 does get the kill onto Mad in the meantime. Now Kroki going into work onto Paris with his usage of the Metamorphosis. He's getting chased down. They don't have No-Tail to glimpse him back. And he should survive. That went not that great for denial. In fact, you can look at S4. He's still chasing after Paris, yeah. But he should be able to get out, I think.
I mean, he's only getting the kill onto the support of No-Tail for... Let's see, they trade the Reincarnate, the Nyx, as well as the Viper.
Oh, he hit Creo! Is it enough, though? I don't think so, but... That was a nice shot. Maybe he will die out of the Shatter. Now, he looks like he will stay alive. That's very close, though. What a snipe coming up from Puppy. Still, though. Level 1 ult doesn't provide that much, sadly.
A little unfortunate, and Kuro just doing so much damage in that last fight. Doesn't even have a point into Reflection. A lot of Terrorblades, they just completely skip this skill. It's actually not very useful. It's sort of that the same reasoning why you don't get...
Oh, Veneta mid lane. Hill's gonna go. Big Dreamfall coming in. Illusorb waiting rift. Static Storm on top of it all. They're getting low. Boom. Both will go down. The Ice Blast coming in. It helps out. And Doom does get one of them. Now here comes Mad trying to get away. He does the double damage rune, but Spike Carapace already on cooldown. Try to get the Impel off. S4 is taking over this game with some beautiful Dream Coils. They're making it easy for him.
Yeah. We've actually seen a real resurgence in the Puck hero, especially in the mid lane, especially like teams like Secret, C9. And I feel like every time I see Puck in games recently, especially in the mid lane, the hero just gets out of control. Like, it's so good at counter ganking. It does pretty much fine in all of these mid lane matchups, and it's just really good at controlling the game, especially for these hard carries.
Is your end game mic on F4L?
It is.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, excellent. Just making sure someone mentioned to me otherwise.
It was off at the draft at the very beginning.
Okay, I just sent this guy message. All right, my apologies. I didn't mean to. I'm yelling at you. But 15-6 is the score, and Denial's getting, I wouldn't say shut out, but it's about as close as you can get in this game. Because Kuroki's almost got his man style. They are going to try to gank him. Matt's going to come in. They're going to find out Kuro. They know that this is the real hero. So they're going to chase him down.
They don't get the skill. It's pretty much the story of the game. He's just so fast right now. You have to impale pretty soon.
Vendetta's going to go. No, it's over. The impale's going to fly. He Manta's away from it. He had just got that Manta style. The Viper Strike does come out. They're chasing Kuro down. He might have died. He's going to TP away. And we'll make it out. Droom Coil onto two. Paris is going to get Doom. No, rather, it's going to be Mad. And he'll get chased down. Right clicked. He's dead. And they will relocate back out. They lose the Dark. So Jarral, he's going too deep. Static Storm coming in. And Puppy will make it away as well. Jarral's going to work on getting No-Tail. He might get this kill. But in the end, he probably will die. Glimpse is available for No-Tail if he wants to use it. He might. Illusorb, he's trying to jaunt. Juke jives. There's the Waiting Rift coming in as well. The right click will get the kill, but it's a monster kill for S4. He is one kill away from godlike. And like you said, it's the story of the game. They couldn't even get Kuroki there. My god.
Yeah, Kuroki lives, and he's the main priority target. If it doesn't even matter, and Secret are trading very well in these fights without Kuroki, so if you look at the fight recap, 1,000 gold, 2,800 experience in the way of Secret.
It's becoming
honestly,
an issue.
Honestly, this lineup for Denial doesn't really have any sort of comeback mechanic. Sure, you could say the Darkseer wall vacuum combo, but there's no AoE follow-up to that combo. Like, usually, if you want to come back with the Darkseer, you would have some sort of AoE. They have the Impale, but that's not as reliable as something like, you know, a Ravage or a Ice Path even, because you can Ice Path and then vacuum on top of it. So I think it's going to be very difficult for them to come back into this game.
They will find no tail from that, but he's not going to get the kill. They're just going to cold feed him, and he's dead. He's just dead. Simba gets the kill with level death, and that's pretty nice. But and the Wraith King as well, what is he really providing this game? Like one reincarnation every, you know, I guess 120 seconds now, but...
I mean, I do like that he went for the Midas in the safe lane because this hero is all about getting up to that level 16.
Well, he's gonna die, it looks like. Silence is gonna come through and he's gonna get relocated out. The Dream Coil came in and it actually got canceled. Creo could not relocate out. Paris is gonna get caught. There's the reincarnation coming in on the backside. They're looking for Creo. He's gonna fall. Viper Strike, did that miss? It did. S4 avoids it with his phase shift. Paris is gonna get doomed up. A lot of rotations coming in from the side of Denial. They're looking for something here. S4 is getting chased down. There's the kinetic field to stop Troll. Illusorb comes in, but well, he's not doing any damages. He does have the magic resistance from Corrosive Skin, but they get Creo. They force out the reincarnation. They're happy with that. And again, it's just one fight after another that Secret are having some trouble with, it looks like, and or rather Denial.
And where was Kuroki?
Up top. He was farming.
Farming away.
He was ricing up like nobody's business.
They also used the reincarnate, so that's going to be on cooldown for the next 2 minutes. I completely missed that kill.
I missed it too. Don't even worry. Listen, it's fine.
Yeah, and S4 is actually, he's picked up a dagger now, so.
Zap. He's going to zap some people.
I actually really like this Dagon choice against the Wisp particularly because he can just Waning Rift Orb and Dagon him and he's always going to die. I think it's very effective against Wisp, especially. I think anytime you're going for the Dagon on Puck, you should always go it against supports that you can one-shot.
It's gonna feel not great for this IO pick. Brio's going to have a rough time. He already has a rough time in this game. I mean, you want this IO pick to be effective and aggressive. And more so than anything else, he's just died. Like, they haven't gotten any kills off of a relocate gank. A lot of the time, there's been a glimpse involved. I really think the disruptor choice was great. S4 is sitting in the trees here. He's trying to hide away from Paris, and he will do so. For now, it's just... I think all you really need to do for Secret is continue to get Kuroki farmed. And then at some point, you're just going to take this game. There's no real way to stop him. And they're going to go into Creo. The Waning Rift of the Dagon comes in plus one right click. And S4 just says, thank you very much for the gold. He is 11-0-5. He is beyond godlike. He has yet to die in this game. They're going to chase after Kuroki. There will be the Impale coming in from Mad. Yeah, he already used his Vendetta Mana Burn. There's going to be the Rupture, rather the Sunder, excuse me. This is not a Bloodseeker. This is a Terrorblade. Thunderstrike going in. Mad is dead. He's going to go down. Glimpse back into Funzie as well. It's just that type of game, my friend.
And we're probably looking at a 23-minute Scotty, I think, for Kuroki. And that's pretty much the perfect timing for the Scotty on this hero with the Manta.
Montpax throws at the stat as well. This is a personal best off for 20 kills, or for rather for kills on a puck at 20 minutes for S4, so a PR indeed. There's the reincarnation. Big Daddy's going to TP out. Wraith Fireblast might go. No, he was fogged up. They couldn't see him. Blink forward. They're going to try to go on this day again. I mean... That's what happens, man. If the IO is anywhere close to S4, he's just going to kill him.
Yeah, I talked about the effectiveness of the Dagon, especially against the IO hero, which it's a hero that has to stay... It's a support hero that has to stay within the range of the carry, so usually you can always know where he is. And it's just so easy for S4 to snipe him off this game. How many times has he died? Five deaths.
Yeah, he's got a couple to his name. It's not as much as I thought, but... Yeah,
Matt and Funzie have actually died more on their respective heroes, but...
Wow, 9 deaths for Mad. That is, it's a rough game.
I mean, he has to be in more precarious positions than the Wisp because, you know, he's a melee hero, first of all, and he has to get in to cast his stun, and he's been trying to, you know, set up some pickoffs onto the Terrorblade, none of which have worked.
And he's probably gonna die again here. Cold feet going in. Meanwhile, S4 kills a hero on the back end. That was Funzie going down, and they will pick up another kill. Kuroki getting the one onto the Nyx Assassin. You make a good point. This is the problem with the Nyx Assassin as a support. You're not getting the farm to get a Blink Dagger, and I mean, you're setting up pickoffs that are very, very, very dangerous, more so than anything else.
I mean, ideally, you would like to be the 4 position if you're going to play support and then find the farm for the Blink, but when you're behind like this, you're definitely not going to have that option.
No, there's really no luxury coming out for the Nyx Assassin in this game. They actually haven't even taken the tier 1 bottom yet, despite having 28 kills. They're up 21 kills on Denial right now. Ags is already done for Simba. Mad's going to come in. They should have a gem for S4. He's actually not there currently. There's the Scotty, by the way. You said 23 minutes. You were right on the money. Mad is probably dead. Big Daddy is getting brought down by Paris, and he actually will fall, but here comes this Scotty Kuroki, and Paris is slowed up. He's getting chased down. The relocate coming in as well. Paris probably should survive this. Ice Blast is going to whiff.
Kuroki can actually fight all these heroes still.
Yeah, I mean, he certainly can go toe-to-toe, but they're going to wait and push in the creep wave and then go for it. Metamorphosis is still up for about, what's the duration at level 4? 52 seconds, I'd say about 30 seconds or something.
Yep. It takes S4 0.6 seconds to kill Io. Yep.
Well.
And if he continues leveling the Stagon, he can nearly one-shot him.
Bunzi, what are you doing? Draw's going to get brought down low with the Sag Scepter Doom, but they're not going to get the kill. Instead, they're going to go on to Paris. That's Reincarnation. Wow. BKB was picked for Draw. Kuroki is just melting Paris. He's actually just dead. Ice Blast, boom! Puppy snipes him from long range from downtown, and that's going to be the GG call coming in 24 minutes in. And Secret just run over Denial. There's no other way to put it than that. What a game coming out from your dire side, Secret obliterating Denial.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't like this support duo that they had, the Wisp and Nyx, because you want the Wisp to be a hero that sits on a lane, and then you need the other hero to be able to control the game.